Hey, Sam. I'm on 5 minutes still, so we're not doing this at the end. We're going to, we'll start at 45.
Just hit stop it, and then when the next person on the podium, you're going to stop it.
Right back at you. If you have something that is not on the beat, for, for instance, clarinet 1, 2, and horn. So Sarah and which one? Who's clarinet 2? Since we have bassoon, and bassoon and bass clarinet have, for the most part, the exact same part, we'll just have you play clarinet 2 unless you really feel inclined to play bass clarinet part.
I'll just play it.
And what's the focus?
I really want to make sure we emphasize and bring out the different parts that aren't always on the beat and focus on pulling out things that other sections don't have and making sure we hear every single different difference.
Good.
All right. So starting at 45, make sure you bring out something if you're not on the downbeat and make sure it's still a bell tone like at the beginning.
Detracts from the clip, the clarity of that point of inception. Okay. But just try that again. Try keeping everything still except that.
Okay. 53, we'll do 4 bars this time.
Thank you.
to, yeah, 69. This time it's going to be alto sax 1, I'm assuming is what you're playing, Darby?
Yeah.
Alto sax 1 and trombone 1, which we actually don't have.
What's
so we won't.
What's the order of the notes?
Trombone 1 has a D 4.
Okay.
All right. Well, we'll just go to a different section because I wanted him here to play that.
Yeah, almost out of time, so let's just do this one section.
Okay. Let's go to 77 real quick.
Your face is conducting. In fact, it's your most important tool as a conductor, is your face. Great job. Well, let me